Economic activity refers to the actions that generate the production of goods and services, employment, and incomes. You can look at economic activity on two different scales, large or small, macro or micro. Macroeconomics describes how the overall economy works. It looks at how the market, institutions, government, and other large-scale systems behave. By contrast, microeconomic activity takes place on the small scale. It includes how individual people and businesses organize and behave to keep the economic activity going. Here, we're looking at the big picture, macroeconomic activity. Economic activity expands and contracts on a cyclical basis over time. This is called the business cycle. It generally follows an upward trend. There are two major influences on the business cycle: aggregate demand and aggregate supply. Aggregate demand is the total annual spending on locally made goods and services. It has four main components: private consumption spending by households, C; private investment spending by businesses, I; total government spending, consumption and investment, G; and net exports, which equals exports, X, minus imports, M. As a mathematical equation, aggregate demand equals private household consumption plus private business investment plus total government spending plus net exports. When aggregate demand weakens, it signals a slowdown or contraction in the level of economic activity. As GDP decreases due to lower aggregate demand, the economy contracts. At the bottom of the cycle is a trough. Production levels are low and unemployment is high. If this negative growth persists, an economy goes into recession. There is no single definition of an economic recession, although commentators often refer to a technical recession. They define this as two consecutive quarters of negative growth or economic contraction. If the economic outlook continues to worsen and GDP keeps declining, an economy can go from a recession into a depression. A depression is a much more severe version of a recession. The decline in GDP is longer and the accompanying unemployment is higher. The economy continues to contract until the business cycle hits the trough. While falling production and high unemployment occur during economic contraction, inflation tends to remain low. An increase in aggregate demand signals the expansion in economic activity and production. Economies are said to boom when they go into an expansion phase. This continues until they reach a peak. At the peak, employment levels are high. Businesses operate with production levels at or approaching capacity. A growing economy is a good thing, but growth must be sustainable. If it's too rapid, inflation increases, prices rise rapidly, and the economy overheats. The economy's productive capacity can't meet growing aggregate demand. GDP decreases, the economy begins to contract, unemployment rises, inflation decreases, and so the cycle continues. While economies go through cycles of contraction and expansion, there are no prescribed timelines. This makes economic forecasting very difficult. An economy can be in either phase for varying lengths of time. It can trend upward or downward very quickly or very slowly. It can also stagnate with zero or minuscule growth. The blue line on this graph shows the ideal trend for the business cycle: a trajectory of smooth growth. Governments and central banks try to smooth the growth path in line with historic growth rate trends by applying monetary, fiscal, and supply-side policies. Let's look at the other major influence on the business cycle: aggregate supply. This is the total annual quantity of goods and services produced by all businesses. An increase in aggregate supply leads to the long-term upward trend in the business cycle, seen as essential to the economic health of a nation. Think of aggregate supply as a bit like the speed limit of the economy. As aggregate demand rises, aggregate supply must increase to keep pace with it and to ensure continued economic growth. If demand exceeds supply, the speed limit is broken and overheating occurs. High material living standards allow access to more goods and services, which requires continued economic growth. High non-material living standards include personal freedom and safety, good friends and neighbors, and a healthy environment. Living standards are influenced by environmental quality, per capita income, and wealth distribution. Income is the money an individual receives over a period of time. Wealth is the set of assets an individual holds at a given point in time. Even in advanced economies, wealth is very unevenly distributed. For example, in the US, the wealthiest 10% of the population own around 80% of the nation's wealth. Economies are complex and are impacted by a wide range of factors. Macroeconomics is about the big picture and how aggregate demand and supply drive the business cycle.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.